Good morning. We had three funerals and one interment this week. James Ellis, Charlene Sitars, Robert Shaw, and Gervais McKenna. So we keep these families and Gervais, Robert, Charlene, and James in our prayers as we come to the Eucharist. Our Catholic Women's League had a wonderful bake sale last weekend and raised $1,700. So thank you very much for your support. We had Share Life corporate golf tournament was last Monday, and they debuted the film about the refugee that Arthur Peters talked about last Sunday. And so you can see that video, that Share Life video, on our website. If you scroll down, you can see the YouTube video from the Archdiocese Share Life account, and tells that story of our refugee that we've been supporting here at St. Mary's. We're already at $92,000 for our Share Life campaign, and so thank you for that. And our goal of $110,000, you can keep giving to Share Life throughout the summer and the fall. We had a Zoom meeting with our this week. The Wednesday was the perfect day with sunshine and no rain, and that was our barbecue for the priests of Simcoe County and Bishop Wassenaar. And we had a great Edge finale on Friday evening, and Captain Amen had to get pelted by water balloons. The kids had fun and I had to change. So. It's the feast of the Most Holy Trinity, the Solemnity, Trinity Sunday. I'm your homilist and your presider. I invite you to stand and sing. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. the grace and peace of God our Father, the Lord Jesus Christ, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you always. My brothers and sisters, as we come together on this great feast of the Trinity, we recognize our need for God's mercy and compassion in our lives. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, you forgive us your sins. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, earth peace to people of good will. We adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, O God Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. Glory to God in the highest, you alone are the the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. God our Father, who by sending into the world the Word of Truth and the Spirit of Sanctification, made known to the human race your wondrous mystery, grant us, we pray, that in professing the true faith, we may acknowledge the Trinity of eternal glory and adore your unity, powerful in majesty. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. Thus says the wisdom of God. The Lord created me at the beginning of his work, the first of his acts of long ago. Ages ago, I was set up, at the first, before the beginning of the earth. When there were no depths, I was brought forth. When there was no springs abounding with water, before the mountains had been shaped, before the hills, I was brought forth. When he had not yet made earths and fields, or the world's first bits of soil, when he established the heavens, I was there. When he drew a circle on the face of the deep, when he made firm the skies above, when he established the fountains of the deep. When he assigned to the sea its limit, so that the waters might not transgress his command. When he marked out the foundations of the earth, then I was beside him, like a master worker, and I was daily his delight. Rejoicing before him always, rejoicing in his inhabited world, and delighting in the children of Adam. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, since we are justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have obtained access to this grace in which we stand. And we boast in our hope of sharing the glory of God. And not only that, but we also boast in our sufferings, knowing that suffering produces endurance, and endurance produces character. And character produces hope, and hope does not disappoint us, because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that He has given us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Mm-hmm.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said to his disciples, I still have many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. When the Spirit of truth comes, he will guide you into all the truth. For he will not speak on his own, but will speak whatever he hears, and he will declare to you the things that are to come. He will glorify me, because he will take what is mine and declare it to you. All that the Father has is mine. For this reason I said that he will take what is mine and declare it to you. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. One plus one plus one equals one. That's Catholic math for you. For decades, for years, for centuries, for millennia, with shamrocks or clover or whatever, people, saints, authors, have struggled to find that most perfect analogy for to describe the perfect love, the perfect relationship of the perfect Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, the perfect God, the perfect Holy Trinity. The Most Holy Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. The Unholy Trinity is me, myself, and I. And I think about the Trinity as all about relationship. I am a son, I'm a brother, I'm an uncle, but I'm just one person. Three different kinds of relationships, one person. And sometimes we talk about this mystery of the Trinity, and we call it an unobtainable mystery in a sense. Is it solvable? No, it's not like a case on the news or a TV show like CSI or something like that, but rather a mystery that we can continually always discover more of the truth. That's what Jesus is saying in the gospel today. You know, you can't handle the truth. You can't handle it right now, all that I need to say, want to say to you, but the Spirit will reveal it to you. And over time, we will be able to plunge the mystery of the Trinity more and more. And yet not fully understanding the mystery doesn't mean that we can't access the mystery. Years ago, in another parish, I had an associate pastor who had been a mechanic. And so he knew cars. I don't know cars. I know you don't turn the key anymore. You push a button. But and you put gas in and all that sort of stuff. And I know that I need to take it to someone who knows more about cars at times. But not knowing about cars doesn't mean I don't access the car. I can drive, I can travel. And I'm not really sure how electricity works, but that doesn't stop me from using lights and television and computer. Even though we can never fully comprehend the mystery that is the Most Holy Trinity, that does not stop us from accessing and relating to our triune God. Even though we grow in our understanding, in fact, in accessing the Trinity here at the table of the Lord, we get to share in the very body and blood of Christ, and we access the Trinity, the lover, beloved, love, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. O Lord our God, how wonderful your name through all the earth. As a family of faith, we profess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. My sisters and brothers, as we marvel that God loves us as he loves his only Son and bestows on us his own Spirit, let us join our prayers to Christ as we intercede for the needs of the Church, all families, and the salvation of all people.
For unity among the baptized that reflects the divine love and community of the Trinity. For Pope Francis, all bishops, and for all priests and deacons who baptize in the name of the Trinity, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For students preparing for exams, for those graduating, for all people searching for employment, and for all people experiencing financial hardship, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the peaceful resolution of all disputes, especially in Ukraine. For all people traumatized by mass shootings in Nigeria and throughout the world, in malls, schools, and churches. And for those who commit acts of violence, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Indigenous leaders, for all survivors of intergenerational trauma, and for all who hunger for truth, reconciliation, justice, and peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all families who seek to live with one heart, mind, and spirit, and for those who know the pain of loneliness, of broken relationships, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the spiritual and physical well-being of all parishioners, for all who are sick, including Miriam Keegan, Calvin Barton, Carmelita Jacinto, Margaret Boland, and all those on our parish sick list, We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died in Christ recently, including James Ellis, Robert Shaw, Charlene Sitars, Gervais McKenna, and for all who mourn, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Triune God of awe and wonder, hear our prayers and draw us deeper into the mystery of your life, that as you share with us the love that binds you as one, so may we dwell in unity with you in your church. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours might be acceptable to God, the Father, the Almighty. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and the good of all God's holy church. Sanctify by the invocation of your name, we pray, O Lord our God, this offering of our service, and by it, make of us an eternal offering to you, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for with your only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit, you are one God, one Lord, not in the unity of a single person, but in a trinity of one substance. For what you have revealed to us as your glory, we believe equally of your Son and of the Holy Spirit, so that in confessing of the true and eternal Godhead, you might be adored
in what is proper to each person, their unity in substance, and their equality in majesty. For this is praised by angels and archangels, cherubim too, and seraphim, who never cease to cry out to each day, as with one voice they acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread. Giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the offering of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one Spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth,
with your servant Francis our Pope and Thomas our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. 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 At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Amen. Share with one another a sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold the risen Lord who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those called to the banquet of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Thank you. Let us pray. May receiving this sacrament, O Lord our God, bring us health of body and soul as we confess your eternal Holy Trinity and undivided unity through Christ our Lord. Amen. I invite you to be seated for a moment. This afternoon at 2 o'clock at the corner of Bayfield and Cundles on the northwest corner, there will be the rosary prayed in the public square, and that's at 2 o'clock this afternoon. There's no life team tonight, despite what's in the bulletin, and stay tuned for ultimate updates. That's updates on the ultimate frisbee practices. Christian meditation is Tuesday morning online at 10:30, and that link is on the website. And faith nourishment, or vitamin F, is in person on Tuesday evening at 7:30, looking at ordinary time. There's nothing ordinary about ordinary time. And our ministry with maturing adults is celebrating the gift of years at 2 o'clock on Wednesday, 2 o'clock in the afternoon, and it's here in the parish hall. And our refugee committee is meeting at 7 o'clock on Thursday evening. And this month, the month of June, is Seniors Month in Ontario, and so we have a blessing for those in the second half of life. So you get to self-select here about if you're in the second half of life or not. So I invite those in the second half of life to stand for a blessing. Now you're all looking around to see who thinks they're in the second half, right? Let us pray. Most loving God, we thank you for the gift of years granted in our time to so many women and men in the second half of life. We thank you for their presence in our parish community, for their life experience, their courage and wisdom, their witness of faith. We ask your blessing upon them as they live the many transitions that are part of maturing years. Be with them, keep them in your care, grant them peace, and enable them to become beacons of hope in our world through Christ our Lord. Amen. Now, I'm not going to go around saying how old. Invite everybody to stand. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Thanks be to God.